Hello, my name is Eran Stern and welcome to the Getting Started tutorial for Stardust, a modular particle system for After Effects. In this tutorial, I'll show you the basics of this plugin and how to get the most out of it. We'll explore the different tools and see how fast and easy it is to create complex particles using this effect. So first, let's just see what is the best setup for the plugin. I'm going to create a new comp. It's going to be a full HD, in my case, 3 seconds long. I'm going to say okay. And then I'm going to create a new solid. And this is going to be a repetitive task over here. So every time that you are applying Stardust, you need to apply it to a solid, which has the same dimensions of the composition. So make sure to click on the make comp size button. I'm going to say okay. And then under effect, superluminal, I'm going to choose Stardust. Now this window will pop up and you can of course dock it in your interface like so, or you can just rearrange your panels and then save them out as a layout or a workspace in After Effects terms. And this is what I did in my machine. So I'm just going to click on the Stardust button over here and a few panels will disappear and I'm going to get only what I need. And by that I mean that we have three main areas that we need to work with when we are using Stardust. The main thing is this Stardust effect, which is applied first. And then we have the Stardust panel, and underneath, back in the effect controls inside After Effects, we have all those tools which I'm going to cover in this tutorial. But first, just so we'll have something nice to look at, I'm going to click over here where all the icons are, and this will get me to the Stardust presets, which we are going to use from time to time in order to demonstrate a few of the settings over here. I'm going to start up with one from the backgrounds, and I'm going to click on these red circles and choose replace in order to replace everything that I have so far in my scene. Now, just so you can get a sense of what I've created, I'm going to press spacebar in order to generate a quick run preview. All right, let's just climb up and once again talk about the principles. Every time that we are using Stardust, we have the Stardust main effect, and over here you can control things like time remapping. You can switch it on or off, and you can animate it using this time seconds slider. You can also control the render settings, and those are the main particle settings. So for example, if I'm going to turn on the preview here and reduce the particle chance, think about it in percentage, to say 25%, we're actually going to render 25% out of everything that we are building. So this can help you to speed up your renders in case you just want to check how everything is looking before committing it to the final render. In any case, I'm just going to tick it off, which will of course disable the feature. And then I'm going to show you that you also get access to helpers. Now, if I'm going to turn on helpers, in this case, we don't have anything to visualize. So this is something that will show you, for example, things like field. So if I'm going to apply a new node and I'm going to return and explain what each and every node is doing. But in this case, we can see that the field is over here and we get a representation of how it's going to look. In this case, the field type is sphere, but if I'm going to change it to a box, we'll have some sort of a visual aid over here. All right, I'm going to select this guy and press delete or backspace on the keyboard in order to get rid of it. I'm also going to switch off the helpers. We can also enable or disable motion blur. You can also do the same for shading, depth of field, Z buffer, clipping, and other render settings. I'm just going to trill them up for a moment. And then under the advanced, you have a few more technical properties which you can change. I'm not going to cover everything in this basic tutorial. Just think about it as where you are setting the preferences for this effect. All right, the next section is what we are seeing over here. And this is, of course, the node base. And we will see how much flexible it is compared to other methods of working inside After Effects. We have also this tiny window which will help you to navigate when you have something which is more complex. You can also just change the window over here, and the moment that you have enough room, this guy is going to go away. Now, few other technical stuff that you may need to know or be aware of is where you are selecting something here in this panel. For example, if I'm going to highlight the emitter, it's going to light up over here at the effect controls panel. And by that, I mean that we can see a green line over here, meaning that this is the selected node. I'm just going to rename it to something else, just in order to show you that everything is going to be reflected over here as well. This is true also for deleting stuff. So if I'm going to select one of the particle nodes over here and press delete on my keyboard, it's going to go away from the schematic view as well as from the effect controls list.